The strong winds are finally starting to calm down, but not before wreaking havoc across the state. In Aina Haina, some of the public library's photovoltaic panels blew off. The 288 panels were installed 3 years ago as part of the state's push to go green. The library was the first on Oahu and second in the state to install the system, which generates over 70% of the library's monthly energy needs. We wanted to know how the panels came off and what you should do if this happens to you. Nestor Garcia has been looking into it. Ness, what did you find?
Joe, we came across the loose panels at the Aina Haina Library, and I informed the fire department. I was told to be careful because even with the panels damaged, there was still the danger of a shock hazard. This morning in Aina Haina, a makeshift sign at the library notified people about the problem. Several panels of its photovoltaic system apparently broke free sometime early Sunday morning. A library spokesman says the debris did not injure anyone and the panels did not damage any cars or property nearby.
A library spokesman says the state was contacted about the loose panels and that he had been assured that the state had secured the panels, but as you can see, the panels are stored here in the back of the library, easily accessible to anyone who walks behind the building.
We notified the fire department of the panels at Aina Haina, and I was told not to touch anything. I was told there is the danger of a shock hazard if a number of panels were connected together and still carried a charge with wires damaged and exposed.
In spite of any kind of system, if it's damaged or on the ground, still hazardous?
Absolutely. Whether it's a string inverter type or it's a microinverter setup, it's still considered dangerous, especially if it was blown off of a roof, if it was involved in a fire.
If it's damaged or on the ground, still hazardous?
Absolutely. Whether it's a string inverter type or it's a microinverter setup, it's still considered dangerous, especially if it was blown off of a roof, if it was involved in a fire. If you find it laying on the ground, just to stay away from it, call 911. We'll have the fire department come down, isolate the area.
As for the risk of exposure in this case, the state released a statement saying, "We are still in the process of determining the sequence of events and do not have enough information to address the issue at this time." As to the issue of whether PV systems can hold up to stormy conditions, I turn to the president of the Hawaii Solar Energy Association.
What do you tell them to assure them that it's secure?
Well, the manufacturers have certifications that have to be there. The city and county does have UBC, IBC building codes that we strictly have to adhere to, well over 100 miles an hour.
Now, we want to know why these panels did not stand up to the wind, and we were told by the state that it will work with the design consultant and with the PV installer to investigate and to make sure this does not happen again. After they learned of the Aina Haina situation, the fire department told state officials to store the loose panels in a more secure location, and the state fixed them. Nestor Garcia, KHON2 News.